All right, we're gonna try a full length bumblebees. All right, I have gone ahead and already foiled my pieces. We're gonna need a soldering iron. We're gonna need some flux, and we're gonna need some solder. And I like using these little pinchy pliers. I just need some solder and I'm good to go. So we'll lay out the pieces. All right, it's really important to make sure that these suckers are straight, otherwise they will throw the balance off. So I just put a straight object down the middle and alter it a little bit. It's also kind of important that these line up well, even though we're gonna make it three dimensionals. So I start by applying flux. Just in the places where it, ooh, see, because that'll happen. And then you gotta readjust. All right. Make sure you got a wet sponge. All right. So I'm just gonna start by tacking it together so my pieces don't move around on me. Okay. And I'm gonna separate my pieces. Give a nice flux. And then I coat the edges. I like to have a nice thick rounded bead. I don't like to see the seam. And there's two problems you can have while you're soldering. Either too much flux or not enough. If you have too much, it will spit at you. And if you don't have enough, the solder will like peek up at you. If it happens, I will point it out. All right, whoopee. Now we'll do the edges. So the key with the soldering iron is one side is flat and the other side is pointed. So if you want to pick up the solder and travel with it, you want to keep it like this. If you want the solder to go off, you turn it like that. So if you want to travel, carry it like this. I call this the slow pat. You want to keep your project level and create a nice rounded bead on the edge. See how it's a little not so nice? We're going to apply a little more flux there. Go over it again. Give it a 1, 2, 3, and rotate. Do the same thing to the bees. This is also the time I like to pick up all the little bits off my table. So I'm doing the edges. You also got more on your table as well. Running away from me. Oops. Actually, that's an okay view. Alright. Actually, let's do it. Sorry about that. Okay. So I'm making mine three-dimensional. So how I do that is I grab my pliers and I hold my bee on the angle that I want it to be at. Ooh, we're a little bit out of frame here. Okay. This is probably the trickiest part. It's not so much getting this one, but it's making them mirrored on the other side. That is tricky. Same. So we'll turn it on its angle so you can have a straight upright view of it. Okay. How's that? Ooh, pretty good. Okay, now is the beautifying. That same slow tap that I do on the edges is how I fix all of my seams where they join. So after going around the edge, you usually need to touch up the fronts and backs. People just want to stop when you're done the edge, but it's all about those finishing touches. You also want to really make this joint here really strong, because that's what's holding the wings onto the body there. And if you're having some leak throughs, apply a little bit of flux. It'll cool the surface and allow you to put some more on there. Sometimes it takes a couple flips to get it perfect too. When it leaks through on one side, you gotta fix it on the other, and then you're going back and forth, back and forth. Gets pretty wiggly when you got flux on there. You see, that's an example of it peaking. So we're gonna apply a little more flux there. And hopefully you have a nice, there we go. Let's see, it's a nice finish there. Don't forget to let it cool down before you move it. Otherwise it'll just run right off like water. I'm pretty happy with this. Last little look over. I'm just giving this a little washy while I make antennas. Now we're gonna make the antennas with some wire. We're also gonna need some wire cutters, some wire benders, and some roundies. So it depends how long you want your antennas to be. But I'm just gonna go ahead and make them this length, which is roughly 1, maybe 2.5 inches. And to make sure that they're symmetricals, grab these pliers, hold your wires together. Right. And I'm gonna use these ends of the antennas as the ring to hang it from. So, once they connect, there we go. I'm gonna give them a little feelsies. And there, now we have two antennas. All right, because I want them to be black. Because I want them to be black, I'm gonna tin them. So I'm gonna cover them with some fluxies. Ooh, there's a bit too much there. All right. Right. Do you have a dirty paper towel? Thank you. Oh, that's so pretty. Here's the bumblebee all washed, scrubbed very well with hot water. Have this silver wire, you can also use copper wire, you can use scraps of electrical, like this is another copper wire that you can use. Then you might want to double up and twist it, get creative. Just gonna clean my wires real quick. Get off some of the flexi mess so I'm not sealing it in there. I did get a little globby there. To the symmetries. Careful, copper does conduct heat, so this wire will get hot if you hang on to it too long. So to make it look like I have eyes, I'm going to overlap them here. And again, with that slow pat, you want to really make sure that it's part of that solder join. I like to turn it upside down so I can make sure that the eyes are kind of even as possible. To give my rings some extra strength, I'm gonna solder them from underneath as well. 2 points of soldering is always better than one. Can I have the black patina? Oh, thank you. All right, we're just gonna have that little bit of flux I added there. Now to make a really nice black finish, you gotta polish a lot. You see that black coming off? And you also want to patina like as soon as possible. Like the longer that any flux sits on there, the worse your finish is gonna be. Copper is like really finicky for that. Flux doesn't, or black patina really doesn't like any flux. Copper patina really does not like any water. So you gotta make sure that you can always fix your wires. There we go. Got a little rainy there, sorry. Sorry, bumblebees. And by polishing it, it also gives you a chance to really go over and make sure that there's no solder points that you want to touch up. Nothing's catching, nothing's sharp. See right there? I'm not such a fan of that. I'm gonna fix her up. Still looking a little flat there. Now we're all better. Take my Windex. Clean her up. Edges are always overlooked, but all right, I think it's good and dry. That all kind of smush off smuts. All right, here comes the magic. Black patinas. And I like using Q-tips. Why? Because Wemyss says if you get this in your eye, you have to wash your eyes for 10 minutes straight. As well as it really cuts down the waste. But obviously make sure that you're using cardboard ones, because the world can use a little less plastic. Kind of gotta flip it and look at all the different angles to make sure that you didn't miss a spot. And the black patina likes to sit and marinate. So I'm gonna leave this puppy overnight and I will polish her up tomorrow. See, barely even used a cup. I'm just gonna wipe off the glass so that the patina doesn't stain it. Bee. A bee.